everyone, welcome to Tesca Technologies Jaipur. Myself Padati, and in today's session we are going to perform an experiment on motorized antenna trainer. Order code is 10020M. The first experiment is assemble the trainer and perform functional checks. And apparatus required for this experiment are: the first apparatus required is the main unit. The main unit consists of directional coupler, modulation generator and a RF generator. Second, we required an antenna trainer. Third, we need a RF detector. Next apparatus required is the detector at the receiver end and a folded dipole antenna at the transmitter end. Now, the first step of the procedure of this experiment is, now vary the FS adjust potentiometer of directional coupler to make this display reading 100 microampere. Now, we'll vary till the directional coupler goes to 100. Now, this is approximately equal to 100 microamps. Now, adjust the level of RF detector to show the 3x4 reading of the main unit's display. The output of the RF detector will be shown in the antenna trainer display. In the next step, we need to install the software for this antenna trainer kit. Now, the further steps for the installation of the software of antenna trainer kit are: first, we need to set up this. Now, click to the next button, then next, and so on. We will click and install the antenna trainer software. Now the installation is complete. Now click to the antenna trainer and open the software. After closing the installation process, first go to the computer, then local disk C, program files and the antenna trainer. In the antenna trainer, we'll find the polar graph. After clicking on the right button, we will see run as administration.
Now, we click on this, select the antenna type, the antenna image and the graph pattern image. Suppose I select for the experiment number 1, which is our folded dipole antenna. Then save this. Now select the port. For this experiment, our port is COM2. Baud rate is 9600. Now click on OK. Move towards the settings. Now select the type, which is folded dipole. Number of steps, you can select the number of steps up to 100. For this, I select the number of steps, suppose 10. Now delay by 1.0. You can select the strength minimum and maximum, same.
Now we have to set up the RF detector in this way so that the 75 value which is the 3/4 of the 100 microampere, get displayed on the antenna trainer. We need to start and we will see the graph over here. Now you can see that the antenna is rotating in the 360 degree manner. As you can see, the antenna is rotating from 250 to 260, then 270, and so on. As you can see, the graph plot of the folded dipole antenna is like this. Now, in the next experiment, we will use the Hertz antenna. This is the Hertz antenna. Now, we place the Hertz antenna on the antenna trainer. Now, we place the Hertz antenna on the antenna trainer. We need to move the RF detector in this manner so that an equilibrium state should display on the antenna trainer. In the next step, we need to select the monopole Hertz. Now, save. Then check the port. The port is 2. Baud rate. Then click OK. Now move to settings. Type of monopole Hertz. Number of steps. Here I am selecting 5 number of steps. You can change this strength from 0 to 60 as the maximum strength. The equilibrium position of my antenna trainer was approximately 60. So here I choose this 60. And now I will start this and record the 360 degree rotation of the antenna trainer. Now, as you can see the rotation of the Hertz antenna, it will rotate to the 360 degree clockwise. As you can see, the polar plot of the Hertz antenna is like this. In the next experiment, we will use the Yagi UDA 3 element folded dipole antenna. This is Yagi UDA 3 element folded dipole antenna. Similarly, we put this antenna on the antenna trainer. Adjust the level of RF detector to show the 3/4 reading of the main unit's display, which is 100 microampere. First, we have to click on this, then save the Yagi UDA folded 3 element antenna. Save this. Now check the COM port. Now go to settings. Change the type of folded. Manage the strength minimum and maximum. And then just start. After the 360 degree rotation of the antenna, you can see the graph plot of the Yagi UDA 3 element folded dipole antenna. In the next experiment, we will use the combined collinear array antenna. This is the combined collinear array antenna which we have to connect on the antenna trainer. Now, we have to set up the collinear array antenna and set up all the requirements as mentioned in the previous experiment. After setting the antenna configuration, the graph plot of the combined collinear array antenna is shown here. In the next experiment, we will study the matching stub. Apparatus required for this experiment are: first is matching stub for antenna trainer. A matching stub is a piece of transmission line which is normally short circuited at the far end. Second, we need a main unit and we set the main unit in the reverse direction. We need an antenna stand and a folded dipole 5 element antenna. Now we have to place the antenna on the main unit like this. Keep the stub knob at zero of the matching scale in the zero at this point. Start moving stub knob from right to left slowly and observe the reading on meter of the main unit. Here you can see the maxima and minima of the main unit while we are deviating the matching stub from right to left. Hence we have performed all the experiments of motorized antenna trainer. You can perform more experiments of antenna on antenna trainer kit. For the further details, you can visit Tesca Technologies, and for more queries, you can go through the lab manual which is already provided. Thanks for watching this video. Hope you like it.